trade deficit between Kenya and Japan stands at $335 million as at June 2016, to the disadvantage of Kenya. The mechanisms to bridge this are part of the Kenya private sector agenda at the upcoming Tokyo International Conference on Africa Development right here in Nairobi. Agatha Juma, head of public-private dialogue at the Kenya Private Sector Alliance, joins us now for this and more.
In Africa, Kenya first is a hub. It's easy to get to from most places. But secondly, the business opportunities in Kenya as the gateway to the rest of the region makes it an ideal place for the Japanese companies coming for Ticket 6 and the governments as they're coming to discuss Africa. It's a good entry. So it presents an opportunity for businesses in Kenya to first explore the opportunities that are presented by the business people who are coming here, but also for us to see ourselves in different light, because we're very good at bashing ourselves. But for TICAD to come here means there's something those people are seeing in us that we need to start seeing in ourselves.
Tell us how the business community in Kenya is prepared to engage with the Japanese business community at TICAD 6.
The business community in Kenya has prepared in the sense that they have already expressed interest in participating in the business forum, which will be held on the 26th of August, which will be linking Japanese companies with African companies. There's about 80 to 100 Japanese companies coming, and there are Kenyan companies that also have expressed interest in participating in the business forum. But more importantly, we're partnering with Africa Union Commission, African Development Bank and World Bank Group to host a high-level policy dialogue, which will be held on the 26th, that will be discussing two key issues: infrastructure financing for Africa and agribusiness and productivity. We feel that for the country and at large for the continent, if we unlock these two issues, then we'll be able to do a lot more.
In terms of infrastructure, many times when Japan is investing in Kenya, they do it through JICA.
Yes.
What opportunities is private sector seeing in terms of partnering with people like JICA and bringing the government of Kenya going forward?
The opportunities exist not just with the Japanese government, and we have to say that Japanese have been, in terms of infrastructure development in the country and in the continent, they have been a key resource, because they came in to do infrastructure development before we became sexy and everyone wanted to do infrastructure with Kenya, looking west, looking east, and looking everywhere else. But the opportunities that we see is not even just with government, but with other private companies that are coming. And because now we're getting into the models of PPP, which will grow as we continue, we will be looking to finance these infrastructure projects as private sector. So there is opportunities to partner with finance institutions, private finance institutions in Japan, for more affordable capital to do infrastructure projects, but also with companies where we can do technology transfer for our local companies.
When we talk about discussions around policy, when we're talking about Kenya-Japan relations, what's likely to come about during this conference from a private sector perspective?
We exist to advocate for a conducive business environment. So our work at KEPSA is largely at the policy level, because when you change policy, then you affect more than one company rather than interventions that are company specific. So in our discussions in infrastructure financing, we will be looking at, and we have been cautioned that this is an Africa-wide event. So if we're holding, we can say we're holding brief for the private sector in the continent. As a private sector, as our governments go into infrastructure and getting grants and loans for that, as a private sector, what models can we put in place to ensure that when we do infrastructure, the private sector benefits as well, and not only benefits financially, but more importantly in skills transfer? Are there cheaper ways of doing our roads and our pipelines and our energy plants? We will be learning a lot from the Japanese on that.
Now, I'll take you back to infrastructure. What should Japan be looking at in Kenya in terms of diversifying investment? Because we see some sort of, you know, race between Japan and China to invest in infrastructure. What are the other opportunities as a private sector that you could present to them in an event like Ticket 6, where they could channel their money through companies, also through government directly?
The opportunities that exist for Japanese companies is because largely the investments from Japan have been to do government infrastructure projects. They now also are county infrastructure projects. It's something new that we have gotten into. Mm-hmm. So Japanese companies have an opportunity to come and engage with the Council of Governors and see what they can do, not only on the national highways, but in other projects. But also, as we grow as a country that is focused on industrialization, as we're implementing the Kenya Industrialization Transformation Program, there will be infrastructure projects for the private sector. Construction of factories, value addition, there will be export of already finished products. So the opportunities are immense for Japanese companies and also for Kenyan companies to partner, especially on innovation and technology with Japanese companies for efficiency.
In terms of trade, is there an opportunity to diversify the products that Kenya and Japan are trading in? Because 40% of imports from Japan to Kenya, you know, it's just cars, and mostly we are selling them tea and coffee. What's the opportunity in diversifying this opportunity?
In my opinion, the problem that we face in our trade gaps is, you know, with Japan, it's large. It's $350 million, yeah, which is very large. Yeah. But our problem is historical in that, and it comes from the colonial times, we plant, they take away and value add and bring it back to us. Africa has the steel and it is mined and taken and comes back as cars, which cost, you know, many times more. But I think as a continent, we're going in the right direction. Speaking for Kenya specifically, the Kenya Industrialization Transformation Program means that once we do the leather city in Kenya, we're not exporting wet blue leather. Yeah. We're exporting shoes. Yeah. So there's nothing that we can do at this moment. But give us 6 months, give us 12 months as a region, as a continent, as a country. Yeah. You will begin to see, and I'm very confident of this, our trade gaps reducing. I don't think we necessarily want to move away from tea and coffee. We can do more in tea and coffee because even our tea and coffee is sent out raw. But if we can value add, if we can mill our coffee and send it as processed fine Arabica coffee, it will get us more.